Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I am Dr. Sana Jabeen, working as an assistant professor in Department of Botany, Division of Science and Technology, University of Education, Lahore. Today I am here with the 20th lecture of the course Techniques in Microbiology. This lecture is the continuation of the previous lecture, which was about biochemical analysis of the identification of microorganisms. Let's start with the coagulase test. This test is used to identify Staphylococcus aureus, which produces the enzyme coagulase. Coagulase causes plasma to clot by converting fibrinogen to fibrin. Two types of coagulase are produced by most of the strains of Staphylococcus aureus. Free coagulase, which converts fibrinogen to fibrin by activating a coagulase reacting factor present in the plasma of the blood. Free coagulase is detected by clotting in the tube test. Bound coagulase converts fibrinogen directly to fibrin without requiring a coagulase reacting factor. It can be detected by the clumping of the bacterial cells in the rapid slide test. To perform this experiment, EDTA anticoagulated plasma, maybe from human or rabbit, can be taken. The plasma should be allowed to warm at room temperature before being used in the experiment. First, place a drop of distilled water on each end of a slide or on two separate slides. It's up to you. Then emulsify or mix a colony of the test organisms, which must be already checked by the gram staining, and in each drop to make two thick suspensions. Add a loopful of plasma to one of the suspensions and mix gently. Look for clumping of the organisms within 10 seconds. No plasma is added to the second suspension. This is the control and used to differentiate any granular appearance of the organism from true coagulase clumping. So this will be the control experiment in the second tube, which will be without plasma. This is how the results can be seen. Clumping within 10 seconds shows the Staphylococcus aureus, and if there will be no clumping, then it means there is no bound coagulase, and it will show the negative result, as shown in figure. For positive coagulase control, Staphylococcus aureus can be taken, and for the negative coagulase control, E. coli or other species of Staphylococcus, which is the Staphylococcus epidermidis, can be used. Some other species, for example, virulent strains of Arsenia pestis are also coagulase positive species. To perform tube test method to detect the free coagulase, take three small test tubes and label as T for the test organism, taken from 18 to 24 hours broth culture, label the other test tube with POS, which is the positive control, and the organism, which will be the Staphylococcus aureus, is taken from 18 to 24 hours broth culture. NEG will represent the negative control, and it will be the sterile broth. To perform this experiment, take 0.2 ml of the plasma into each tube, then add 0.8 ml of the test broth culture to the tube T. After that, add same amount of the Staphylococcus aureus culture to the tube labeled as POS, which is the positive control. Then add 0.8 ml of sterile broth to the tube labeled as NEG, which is the negative control. After mixing gently, incubate the three tubes at 35 to 37 degrees Celsius. Then examine for clotting after 1 hour. If no clotting has occurred, examine these slides, these tubes after 3 hours. If the test is still negative, then leave the tube at room temperature overnight and examine it again. When looking for clotting, tilt each tube gently to observe the results. Here you can see how these results can be analyzed. Clotting of the tube contents shows the Staphylococcus aureus, and if there will be no clotting or there will be no fibrogen, and it shows the negative test. A point must be noted that there should be no clotting in the negative control. The other test is the DNase test. This test is used to help in the identification of Staphylococcus aureus, which produces deoxyribonuclease enzymes, that is the DNase enzymes. The DNase test is particularly useful when plasma is not available to perform a coagulase test, or when the results of the coagulase test are difficult to interpret. The principle behind this test is that the deoxyribonuclease hydrolyzes the deoxyribonucleic acid, which is the DNA. The test organism is cultured on a medium which contains DNA. After overnight incubation, the colonies are tested for DNase production by flooding the plate with a weak hydrochloric acid solution. The acid precipitates unhydrolyzed DNA. DNase producing colonies are therefore surrounded by clear areas due to DNA hydrolysis. To perform this procedure, divide a DNase plate into the required number of strips by marking the underside of the plate. That is, you can mark the plate to perform different experiments. Using a sterile loop or swab, spot inoculate the test and control organism. Also, inoculated on the plate. Make sure that each test area is labeled clearly. Incubate the plate at 35 to 37 degrees Celsius overnight. Then cover the surface of the plate with 1 mole per liter hydrochloric acid solution. Look for the clearing around the colonies within 5 minutes of adding the acid. Here you can see clearing around the colonies. This is the clear part around the colony, shows the DNA's positive strain, and if there will be no clearing around the colonies, then there will be the DNA's negative strain. Positive DNA's control is the Staphylococcus aureus, while negative DNA's control species is the Staphylococcus epidermidis. Here in this picture, you can see the numbers 493, 465, and 475 are the positive tests, indicating that the organisms are the Staphylococcus aureus. A positive Staphylococcus aureus control strain is shown on here, the top left section of the petri plate, and it is the positive control, and you can also use the negative control. The organism will be the Staphylococcus epidermidis. In this way, you can perform this experiment to differentiate between these organisms. The next test is the indole test. Testing for indole production is important in the identification of enterobacteria. This is the group of bacteria that is known for their ability to cause intestinal diseases. They are responsible for a variety of human illnesses. For example, most strains of E. coli, Proteus vulgaris, and Providentia species, which break down the amino acid tryptophan and release indole. The test organism is cultured in a medium which contains tryptophan. Indole production is detected by COVAX reagent. This reagent can be economically purchased, and it is ready-to-made reagent. This reagent reacts with the indole to produce a red compound, which shows the results of this experiment. This is how to perform the indole test. There are various ways to perform this test. First one is as a single test using tryptophan water and COVAX reagent. The second is a combined beta-glucuronidase indole test using an indole identification tablet and then COVAX reagent. This is useful when identifying E. coli. We have already studied about the beta-glucuronidase test. The third one is the combined lysine decarboxylase indole test using an indole identification tablet. This test is useful to identify Salmonella and Shigella species. So first we will discuss the detection of the indole using tryptophan water and COVAX reagent. To perform this procedure, inoculate the test organism in a test tube containing 3 ml of sterile tryptophan water. Incubate at 35 to 37 degrees Celsius for up to 48 hours. Test for indole by adding 0.5 ml of Covax reagent and shake it gently. Examine for a red color on the surface layer within 10 minutes of this experiment. Here you can see the results. The red surface layer shows the positive indole test, while if there is no red surface layer, then it will be the negative indole test. The next is the detection of beta-glucuronidase indole using an indole identification tablet and then Covax reagent. Prepare a dense suspension of the test organism in 0.25 ml of the saline solution in a small tube. Add the tablet and then close the tube. Incubate at 35 to 37 degrees Celsius for 3 to 4 hours or maybe overnight. First, read the beta glucuronidase reaction. Yellow color shows the positive test, while if there will be no color, it shows the negative test. Here you can see the yellow color shows the positive beta glucuronidase test and the colorless shows the negative test. Then you will add 3 drops of Covax reagent and shake it. Wait for 3 minutes and then note the reading of the reaction. Examine the color of the surface layer. This will be again the red surface layer shows the positive indole test, and if there will be no red surface, then it will be the negative indole test. A point should be noted that about 94% of E. coli strains are positive and 99% are indole positive. 94% strains are beta-glucuronidase positive and 99% are indole positive. The next one is the detection of lysine carboxylase indole test using an indole identification tablet. To perform this experiment, prepare a dense suspension of the test organism in 0.25 ml of the saline solution in a small tube. Then add a lysine decarboxylase tablet, which is available in the market. Add 3 drops of paraffin oil and close the tube. The oil layer provides the anaerobic conditions which are required for the lysine decarboxylase reaction. After that, incubate at 35 to 37 degrees Celsius for 3 to 4 hours. You may place this experiment up to overnight. Then first read the lysine decarboxylase reaction. This is how it shows the result. The blue or the violet color shows the positive reaction, and the yellow, green or gray color shows the negative lysine decarboxylase reaction. If examining after overnight incubation, a positive test is indicated by a strong blue or violet color. Then you will add 3 drops of Covax reagent and shake. Wait for 3 minutes before reading the indole reaction. After that, examine the color of the surface layer. It will again shows the red color representing the positive indole test, and if there will be no red surface layer, it will be the negative indole reaction. This is all about some of the techniques which are used for the identification of specific types of microorganisms. In next lecture, we will discuss the remaining tests to identify these organisms. For further reading, you may consult this book. Most of the data of this lecture is taken from this book, District Laboratory Practice in Tropical Countries. Thank you.